DNA molecules, including our chromosomes, are composed of nucleotide building blocks, A's, T's, G's, and C's. Two complementary strands of DNA assemble together to make a DNA double helix. The nucleotide sequences of our chromosomes encode instructions for building proteins, which are molecules that carry out most of the functions of life essential for our cells to operate and for organisms to exist. These DNA instructions are located in discrete regions of chromosomes. The parts of our chromosome that encode proteins are called genes. The central dogma of biology tells us that the DNA sequence of a gene is read by a protein that produces a single-stranded RNA transcript, and then a ribosome reads the transcript and decodes its sequence to produce a protein. Like the gene is made up of a sequence of four different nucleotides, proteins are made up of sequences of 20 different amino acids. The linear string of amino acids in a protein then folds, in a very complicated fashion, to produce the three-dimensional structure of the protein. Even subtle changes to the amino acid sequence can have drastic effects on the final function of the protein. Here are two different versions of the same chromosome. Notice that one nucleotide is different. Let's see if we can spot it. And that causes that transcript to be slightly different. And that means that the amino acid sequences of the resulting proteins are different. Because the amino acid sequences of proteins are encoded by the nucleotide sequence of the gene, if mutation changes the DNA sequence, then this can affect the amino acid sequence, and thus the structure and the function of the protein it encodes.